A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 23rd August, on the front page you have Macron, no space for third-party mediation in Kashmir. So this is regarding India-France relations. This is French President Emmanuel Macron who has given this statement. Prime Minister Narendra Modi and visiting French President had discussions, and also India is to receive the first Rafale fighter jet next month, which is from France. So this is the issue covered here. And this is Chidambaram in CBI custody. So we had seen how former finance minister P. Chidambaram had been arrested, and now Delhi court has granted 5-day remand for his interrogation in the INX media case to the CBI. Then below you have Afghan Pashtun fighters poised to enter Jammu and Kashmir. So intelligence inputs have warned that Pakistan is recruiting Afghan and Pashtun fighters for infiltration into Kashmir, and over 100 of them are positioned at various launch pads across the LOC. So this is what Indian intelligence says. So there will be further action here. It seems to be evident now. Then this is Trump suggests India should fight Islamic State in Afghanistan. So US President Donald Trump has named India as one of the countries that ought to be fighting the Islamic State in Afghanistan. So USA wants to leave Afghanistan, but Islamic State is a threat here. And now India being a neighboring country, it says India should be fighting Islamic State. And he says Pakistan is fighting it very, very little. Then this is 9 parties join DMK-led protest. So DMK political party, Dravidra Munnetra Kazhakam from Tamil Nadu, it had initiated this protest for release of political leaders in Kashmir, and now 9 parties have joined this protest. Then this is Rajasthan's free medicine scheme gets first rank. So National Health Mission has given first rank to Rajasthan among 16 states in the implementation of its flagship free medicine scheme. And this is Employee Provident Fund Organization to restore commutation of pension. So this is EPFO, which has approved a proposal to restore commutation of pension or advance part withdrawal under the Employees Pension Scheme. So this would benefit around 6.3 lakh pensioners. So they had opted for commutation and got a lump sum amount at the time of retirement before 2009. But then the changes were made. So this commutation of pension was withdrawn in 2009, but now in 2019, it has been restored. On page 8, you have High Court suspends termination of Navyug deal for Polavaram. So Andhra Pradesh government has suffered a setback because its bid to call reverse tenders for the Polavaram hydropower project has been invalidated by the High Court. High Court has ordered that the letter of termination of contract awarded to Navyug be suspended until further orders. So it says state cannot review and cancel existing tenders once contract is entered into. So contract has already entered into, then you cannot cancel existing tenders. So it was Navyug deal for Polavaram was with the previous government in power in Andhra Pradesh. So new government wanted reverse tendering, but then the contract has already been entered into, is the point which the High Court is making here, you can see. Then on page 9, you have the same front page news, Employee Provident Fund to restore commutation of pension. So this is covered in detail, the issue. And this is Supreme Court refers oxytocin ban to larger bench. So Supreme Court has referred to a larger bench a batch of petitions challenging government notification banning private companies from manufacturing oxytocin, which is a first line drug administered to save the lives of young mothers suffering from excessive bleeding immediately after childbirth. So only one PSU undertaking it. This may result in scarcity, and this issue has been raised before the Supreme Court, which has now been referred to a larger bench. Also, you should know why this ban on oxytocin production by private companies was enforced, because it was said that oxytocin was being misused in the dairy industry, which was affecting the cows. So it was being used for increasing milk production in cows. So this is actually not to be misused in this manner. So to control it, it has been its manufacturing has been restricted to PSU. Private companies are not allowed to manufacture it. But oxytocin is used not just in dairy industry; it is used in humans as such too, for young mothers, as we just discussed. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Internal Affairs. So this says, with the Bangladesh out of the picture, the government should clarify its post-NRC plans. So External Affairs Minister S. Jayashankar, we had seen how he commented in Dhaka that the NRC exercise in Assam is an internal matter. So if it is to be an internal matter, then those who are declared as illegal immigrants, what would happen to them? Because they are called said to be illegal in Bangladeshi immigrants, then how will it resolve that issue? So that's what it said. Government should clarify its post NRC plans. And this is new norms. So this is regarding the news yesterday. SEBI has liberalized norms for foreign portfolio investors, which will make Indian markets attractive to foreign investors. So this issue is discussed here. The lead article, increasing investment to stimulate growth. So this article argues that attention needs to be paid to both cyclical and structural dimensions of India's present economic slowdown. So economic slowdown is evident. Even RBI governor has spoken on it. And now we are here discussing what needs to be done, both on cyclical dimensions as well as on structural dimensions. Then this is taking a Far East turn to deepen a friendship. So this is regarding India-Russia relations. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's visit to Vladivostok, which is proposed now. So it says, the article says, India should signal more willingness to invest in a less developed part of Russia now. This regarding India-Russia relations. Then on Fridays on the op-ed page, you have a Parle coverage where a question is posed and new counterviews are taken. So it's, the question is, should India tinker with its no first use policy? So this is no first use of nuclear weapons, which is a stated nuclear policy. But recently, Defense Minister Rajnath Singh said that this is not something very stringently followed. It may be altered. So he gave such an indication. So he said that future of no first use policy depends on circumstances. So that's a dangerous statement. Then what's the meaning of the policy if it is not to be adhered to? So this is there. On page 13, you have FATF Asia Pacific Group may blacklist Pakistan. So it has listed lack of action on terror financing and money laundering, that and Islamabad has failed in 32 out of 40 parameters. So Pakistan may be blacklisted at Asia Pacific Group FATF meet, which will be concluded in Canberra, Australia. Then below you have UN team alleges violation of rights in Kashmir. So information blackout in Kashmir amounted to collective punishment of the people of the region is what UN Human Rights Council experts have said. And also they said that communication lockdown and denial of fundamental rights to Kashmiri people violated fundamental rights. And also it said that live ammunition is being used on protesters. So that is also a cause of concern. There are night raids in private homes and arrest of young people taking place. Live ammunition was being used on protesters in Kashmir, and that amounted to violation of fundamental right to life. Then on international page here, you have this coverage on the Amazon forests, you know, in northern Brazil. It is said that they have ignited a firestorm on social media with millions joining a campaign with pray for Amazon as a hashtag. So this is fire activity analysis which has been undertaken. So there have been 72,843 fires in Brazil this year. So more than half are in the Amazon region, and it is an 80% increase from the same period last year. So experts blame the fires on illegal loggers who have been burning newly cleared land for cattle ranching and agriculture use. So Brazil has seen massive deforestation since Jair Bolsonaro, the country's new far-right president, who assumed office earlier in 2019. So this is a cause of concern. Amazons are called the lungs of the planet Earth. So they are on fire, lungs are on fire. And below you have, so South Korea scraps key pact with Japan. So South Korea said it will scrap an intelligence sharing pact with Japan, a decision that could escalate a dispute over history and trade and undercut security cooperation on North Korea. So South Korea and Japan relations are also strained, is evident here, with this intelligence sharing pact considered for scrapping by South Korea. On business page, you have tax holiday only for startups with turnover up to rupees 25 crore. So Central Board of Direct Taxes has clarified that startups with an annual turnover of up to 25 crore will continue to get a tax holiday as specified in the Income Tax Act. So this limit is determined by income tax laws, not by the DPIIT notification. So So that's what the Central Board of Direct Taxes says. And this is tax resolution amnesty scheme announced. So government has announced a new scheme aimed at eliminating the bulk of pending tax disputes cases as such. So it will provide partial amnesty to those having tax dues as well. On the last page you have microplastics in drinking water, not a health risk for now. So World Health Organization, which is a UN body, has called for more research into potential future threats because of microplastics in drinking water, but says it's not yet dangerous for humans. Then next is, this is big data helps confront complex disasters. So flood and cyclone forecasting now relies on computer simulations and machine learning. So this is an important step in disaster management. Big data. And this is Russia launches rocket with humanoid robot in space. So this is Fedor, a humanoid robot who will be trained to assist astronauts on the International Space Station. And this is model device to study spread of breast cancer. So these are researchers from IIT Guwahati and Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru. So researchers here have come together and they are collaborating to devise an experimental model for studying medical complication, which is spread of breast cancer cells to other parts of the body through blood. So cancer cells, it is known, they migrate from their point of origin to other parts of the body by transforming into other types of cells such. So that is secondary cancer which is caused, and these breast cancer spreads through blood. So a study on this will be undertaken. So converted cells can migrate through microscopic passages is what researchers say. So they will study the spread of breast cancer. So that is it. Thank you.